the Sri Lanka Foundation Institute, Colombo, a distinguished gathering of politicians, government officials, ambassadors, and stakeholders in Sri Lanka's National Mine Action Programme, all here to commemorate the International Day for Mine Awareness and Assistance to Mine Action in Sri Lanka under the auspices of the Ministry of Economic Development. Individuals involved in the Mine Action Programme spoke on its different aspects and how it has had a positive effect on the lives of local communities.
Mine Action is a success story in Sri Lanka. Let's see how. Mine Action has internationally accepted five pillars. Five pillars are namely mine clearance, stockpile destruction, mine risk education, victim assistance and advocacy. Today, Sri Lanka is considered the most efficient mine clearance program in the world. This is definitely a benchmark in assessing the success of Sri Lanka National Mine Action Program. Mine risk education has reached unprecedented numbers in contaminated areas. Casualty rates are below that expected in the post-conflict situations. MREs even, it's included in the school curriculum today. These indicators are evidence for effective and successful mine risk education. Victim assistance is not directly addressed in the National Mine Action Program, but Ministry of Health is working extensively with the stakeholders in addressing the health component, and Ministry of Social Services is looking after the social integration component through various initiatives.
A role play on mine risk education highlighted the gravity of the issue and the need for concerted action to address it effectively. Sri Lanka's National Mine Action Program was commenced in 2002 and rejuvenated in 2009 following the end of the war. Officials at this event pointed out that the program has today made remarkable progress.
Mine action is undoubtedly the vital enabler for the safe return, resettlement, recovery, and overall development process in Sri Lanka, particularly the war-affected areas in the north and the east. The leadership of the government of Sri Lanka and the strong partnership between government of Sri Lanka, development partners, community at large, United Nations agencies, demining operators, and local organizations have enabled the mine action sector to make remarkable progress over the past years.
According to the National Mine Action Center, initial surveys pinpoint that an estimated 6,215 square kilometers of land area was contaminated with mines and unexploded ordnances. Today, over 4,000 square kilometers have been identified as safe areas, and over 2,000 square kilometers have been confirmed as hazard areas by non-technical surveys. Another significant achievement of the National Mine Action Program has been its ability to help prevent accidents. As of December 2011, 17 incidents with 24 civilian victims from landmine and explosive remnants of war were recorded, which compared to 27 incidents with 47 casualties in 2010. This progress has been possible due to the work of 9 demining operators working in the country, which include national and international agencies. Representing the Army's demining unit, Brigadier Karunaratna highlighted the Army's role in mine clearance.
The field engineers or the sappers of the Army have had invaluable experience in conventional mine warfare in actual battle conditions and are quite competent in the field of mine clearance for military purposes. But they lacked the advanced technical know-how and modern equipment that are available to the INGOs and essentially required for the humanitarian demining. While the INGOs in mine action enjoyed immense financial support from the donor countries, the Army had to rely on the military equipment that were available but not suitable at all for humanitarian demining. During this period, in spite of the reluctance on the part of the donor community to support military directly, for humanitarian mine action, a bold step was taken by the US government to assist the Sri Lanka Army in its humanitarian demining operations, made a significant effect on our performances.
Speaking on the challenges ahead, the director of the National Mine Action Center reiterated the mine action program's future role in the country.
Our vision is to Sri Lanka free from the threat of landmines and explosive remnants of war, where individuals and communities live in a safe environment and the needs of landmine and ERW casualties are met. So our mission is to develop and implement a sustainable national mine action program able to plan, coordinate, implement and monitor all aspects of mine action in Sri Lanka and mobilize the required resources to make Sri Lanka free from the threat of landmines, ERW, through education, threat prevention and elimination in accordance with Sri Lankan national mine action standards.
The event concluded with the launch of the website of the National Mine Action Program by the Minister of Economic Development, Basil Rajapaksa, and an invitation for participants to view an exhibition which showcased the work and equipment used by different mine operators. Although Sri Lanka's mine action program has been largely successful, increased commitment is required by the state in particular, but other stakeholders as well, to recognize the long-term nature of the landmine issue and to work towards addressing it effectively. The National Mine Coordination Structure and the National Mine Action Center would hopefully address existing inadequacies, combine the efforts of interested organizations, and take Sri Lanka forward towards a truly mine-safe and mine-free future.